Welcome to Watercolour Splashes. I'm Lorraine Brown and my artist life is all about watercolour. There is never just one way to paint. In Watercolour Splashes I will show you what works for me. Tips, techniques and experiments that you can try for yourself. Be inspired. Let's watercolour splash. Not every painting that I do of flowers needs to be something pretty. Sometimes I want to just have fun with texture, darker colours, something a little hardier. And so I've chosen today to try and capture the essence of artichokes. These are going to have some colour on them, but I do like them when they're looking dried as well. So I'm not quite sure what I'm going to end up with here, but I'm going to have some fun trying. So let's see how we go. Before I begin any serious painting, I always check the colours that I'm going to use before I start the painting. So I always have little colour swatches. If I've painted a subject many times, sometimes I miss this step because I already have colour swatches and I'll just look through what I've already done and pick something from there. But if it's something I haven't painted, then I will have a little play with the colours first so that by the time I start my painting, I'm not going to make too many wrong choices. Hopefully I'll be on the right track and I waste less paint and I certainly get a painting that I'm more happy with. My subject today is going to be artichokes. I have painted these before, but it was many years ago and I certainly don't have the painting now and I don't have my colour swatches. I want to keep this loose like I do with a lot of florals, so not a lot of pre-designing, but I'd like to get that theory bit worked out first. So having a look at it, if you had a chance to look at my colour mixing, making bright purples, I discovered a purple that I thought would be very interesting for when I want to do this. So even I learned something new from doing that little colour mixing, and I'm now going to be able to use that in this particular application. So I'd already squeezed out a fair bit of this Prussian blue. It was an older tube and I don't know the last time I used it. It could have been donkeys years ago. But I'm going to try using it on this painting because A, I'll get something new that I haven't used for a long time. And it'll look different in my work. And it's nice to have a play with things. And I put it, that's fresh paint, so that's why a lot came out there. I put it with permanent rose here. So this is going to give me my bright purple. So if I put a little bit extra down here, and I put the rose into this now, this is going to give me the purple. And of course it can be a bit darker, it can be a bit lighter. So water will thin it out, thicker paint will make it darker. So I think that's going to be a great choice. I'm looking forward to doing a painting with something new. When you paint and you're a prolific painter, artist like I am, you know, we're always looking for something different to try. And so when you find something like this, you get a little bit excited about what you're going to do with it. So I've got my purple sorted. And of course I will have some that will lean more pink, some will be more blue. But I know I can get a nice fresh looking purple that I want from that. The other thing I'm going to need for the artichokes is going to be the green for their spiky looking leaves, their stems. So I haven't made a choice about that. So what will it be? I was thinking, I'm just wondering about trying some of this Cascade green in this. This is a Daniel Smith colour. When it separates out, so when you use it with a lot of water, it separates out and leaves a bit of a blue tone to it. So it separates out from the green and you end up with some blue. That could be very interesting. But I do need something to warm it up. I'm thinking this Quinacridone gold. If I use that with that green, I'm not sure that I'll particularly like that, but I'm just wondering what it might go like with that Prussian glue. So here, let me put it down again, the gold, and drop in a bit of the blue. That's a lovely fresh green. So I've got a muted bluey green, maybe for background, bright green here if I want it, that I can still dull down. I can drop more blue into it. And do I need anything else? Well, this sort of, these photographs here, just to give me an idea of shapes, this looks very, very fresh. This one here looks a bit more like I've seen artichokes with the dried parts, and then parts that have got this sort of dull, purpley, plummy looking colour on there. But I'm thinking I could probably make that with my rose and maybe putting that gold in there. So it's a very bright orange, which I can dull down a bit, maybe with the blue. It might be too strong. I think it's going to go too green. This is why you have to do these swatches first. That might be more like it. You do the swatches first, because if I had made that onto my painting and ended up with that green and didn't know what I was going to do with it, and I was really committed to the work and I was already in it and used a lot of the paint on the paper, I'd be a bit cross with myself. But by doing 10 minutes of a study, I think I've got it worked out. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to be painting a half sheet painting, and I'll put it on to just video only so you can watch the process. You've seen me choose my colours. I don't even know about the composition, but you'll be able to see what it is that I decide to do. I hope you enjoy watching this. Well, I think I've taken this painting as far as I can for today. It's got very heavy. I mean, that could suit artichokes, but I'm going to have a look at it tomorrow with fresh eyes and just see whether it's worked or not worked. There's certainly a lot of paint on there, and I've enjoyed myself while I've been playing with it. But I will have another look at it in the morning, and as I say, it'll either be a painting or it'll just have been some fun. So till next time, bye.